सहनाभवतु सहनौभुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म उपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्यां मा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्तु अनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरते य उपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐमित्येतदक्षरमुद्गीतमुपासीत ॐमिति ह्युद्गायते तस्योपव्याख्यानम् दहरः उत्तरेभ्यः परमेश्वरेव अत्र धाराकाशो भवितुमर्हति. धर मीन्स् धाराकाशः. द स्मॉल स्पेस् विदिन् द हार्ट् शुड् बि परमेश्वर. मीनिङ्ग् द वर्ड् धाराकाश हियर् यूज्ड् इन् सेन्स् आफ् परमेश्वर परमात्मा और् परं ब्रह्म. वाट् इस् हौ डु यू से दट् उत्तरेभ्यः वाक्यशेषकृतेभ्यः हेतुभ्यः on account of hetubhyah, on account of various reasons that we find in subsequent passages. In this passage, we do not see any mark or any distinction, anything specific to indicate what it is. I mean, if you read only this much, then the passage is subject to more than one interpretations, because the word use the word akasha, when we think that it can be elemental space also, or it can be Parameshwar also. With the word Brahmapuram, it can mean then Vijnanatma, it can be Puram or city of Brahma, which means can mean Jiva or Vijnanatma. So whether this passage is prescribing meditation, this passage is prescribing meditation for sure. Whether it is meditation upon Param Brahma, is it meditation upon the elemental space? Is it meditation upon Vijnanatma or Jivatma? So that is to be determined. Thus, this much brings about these questions and creates these various doubts. Therefore, this discussion here as to what should be the true meaning of the word Dharakasha. Sutrakara says, Parameshwara. Paramatma should be the meaning of the Dharakasa. because of the reasons given subsequently. First is, when the disciples asked, what can there be in that small space within the heart that is to be meditated upon? Well, it is not small space. Yavanva ayam akasha. It is as vast in magnitude, even greater than the space outside. And this compared to the space, therefore, it is not elemental space. It is dhara, does not mean small there. The smallness is only because of upadhi and not because of true nature. Subsequently, then the word is Yesh Atma Apahata Papma. So Dhara Akasha also is Atma. And if Akasha is elemental space, then it is Achetanam. Atma is Chetana. So from that, use the word Atma subsequently for Dhara Akasha also, it eliminates the possibility that Akasha can stand for elemental space. How about Jivatma? Well, true, that in some ways you can interpret the word Brahmapuram or as the Puram or the city of Jivatma. Sin itarebhya karanebhya, for various reasons to be found subsequently, the word Brahma here cannot mean Jiva or Vijnanatma. Because the Purvapakshi said, justifying that, Dhara Akasha can mean Jivatma. He said Jivatma is small and its seat is in the heart. And so it is small, smaller than the heart. It is Aragra Matra, only of the dimension of or size of the tip of a golden stick. So it can be there. So if that is the dimension of Jivatma, then it cannot be compared with the Yavanva ayam akasha. It cannot have that vastness that the space has. So, then if Jivatma is a small entity, then the Shruti has no need to remove the idea of smallness from Jivatma by comparing it with this elemental space, the vast space. It says, no, Jivatma also can be vast. From the standpoint that ultimately Jivatma is Brahma. So okay, if that is so, then why not right away you say that Dhara Akasha is Brahma, rather than saying Dhara Akasha is Jivatma and Jivatma is Brahma, therefore Dhara Akasha can be vast. It's better that right away we say Dhara Akasha is Brahma. Also the argument was that Brahmapuram, this can also mean the city of Jiva. So then the argument was Brahmapuram. So Brahmanaha Puram Brahmapuram. So that is clear. It is a Shashti Tat Purusha Samasa. So what Brahma, which is substantive, is called Prakriti. To that you add the suffix for the sixth case. So Vedanti says Brahmanaha. What should be the meaning of the word Brahmanaha? It is Shashti, means it is Sambandha Shashti. Sambandha can be any relationship, any association can be called Sambandha. That, you know, this Ramakrishna Mission acquires various places in India. Because Swami Vivekananda, like in Baroda, they acquired a big house. Because Swami Vivekananda stayed in the house for 3 days. So that's the association. Bhagavan Swaminarayan came to our house, you know, and so, like that, association can be there. So, association can be general, sambandha, or it can be particular there of the Swa and Swami, of the owner and what is owned or possessor and possessed. So, Jivapuram will mean that the Brahmapuram, that Brahma can be interpreted as Jivatma, provided a specific sambandha, a specific relationship of Sva and Swami, the possessor and possessed. If that is sambandha accepted, then you can say that Brahma can be interpreted as Jivatma. Because Jiva Pranadharana, So this jiva sustains the prana here. And with prana, again, you know, he consumes food, etc. And therefore, is the cause of vṛddhi of this body. In that sense, in some sense, you can say that the word Brahma can apply to jiva also in a derivative sense, not in the prachalita or the rudhyata. But then we say that taking sambandha in general is in fact more important or is preferable to taking a particular sambandha. So a general sambandha is applicable, we should not go for a particular sambandha. So what's a general sambandha? What sambandha or association or relationship Brahman has with this body? That the body is the place of realization of Brahman. Parasyaivedam brahmanah puram sat shariram brahma puram iti uchyate. Brahma shabdasya tasmin mukhyatvat. Number one, Brahma is primarily the param Brahman. Tasyabhyasti. So what Brahman should first be interpreted as param Brahman, because that's the general, the traditional meaning. Then how do you say the city belongs to Brahman? Tasyabhyasti purena anaya sambandha. Even param Brahma also has sambandha or association with body. Jivatma of course has an association as the owner and the own, because his body is earned by Jivatma through his karma. So Jivatma has acquired this body through the karma, and therefore he is the owner in the primary sense. And the hierarchy is like the king owns a city. And just as the king has a palace, so also Jivatma has a dwelling place, which is the lotus of the heart. So it fits in well. That is, if you take the sixth case as this Swaswami, but Brahma primarily means Param Brahma. And if you do not take the sixth case as Swaswami, then Brahman also is sambandha with this body, in terms of the body being the place of realization of Brahma. So martyam va idam shariram aptam mrityana. Even though the body is mortal, it is asya asharirasya amrutasya adhisthanam upalabdhisthanam. It is the place of realization of this immortal and the bodiless Brahman. In support of how this body is the place where Brahman is realized, Bhashyakara quotes a passage, quoted several passages. One passage from the Prashna Upanishad, which is said that a person or upasaka, a meditator, who meditates upon all the three matras of Omkara, qualifies to go to Brahmaloka or beyond that. He realizes, you know, here itself, the self as Brahman. And so it is said that etasma jivaghanat paratparam purisham ikshate. Ikshate, he sees, realizes. Purusham, the person. Who is the person? Purisham, the one who has entered this body. What is his nature? Paratparam. It is superior to even superior. Who is superior? Hiranyagarbha jivaghana. The mass of all the jivas or the conscious beings, the subtle bodies. And this Purusha is superior to even Hiranyagarbha. And that's what the Upasaka sees here. Savayam Purusha Sarvasu Purushu Purishaya. This Purusha, the Paramatma, has entered all the bodies and dwells in the heart. And then Yovedan Hitam Guhaya, one who knows the Paramatma is lost in the cave of the heart. So this is one reason why Brahmapuram should mean the city associated with Brahma rather than the city of Jivatma. Athva, Jivapure, alright. Suppose we take a specific relationship of Swaswami, then you can say that this is the city of Jivatma. Then also, Sannidham upalakshare. Brahma sannidham upalakshare. But in this city also, Brahma is perceived directly. Yatha shalagrama Vishnu sannihitai ditadvat. Just as Lord Vishnu is perceived directly in Shaligrama, so also Param Brahma is perceived directly in this body. So let it be the body of Jivatma. But just as they say, you know, so drishtami rajapare maitra sadma ityardaha. Just as even though the city belongs to the king, a person called Maitra has a dwelling place there, so also even though the city belongs to Jiva, Brahman has a dwelling place, namely the heart. In that sense, even if the word Brahmapura is interpreted as the body of the Jiva, still Param Brahma has association with this, so it is Brahmanapuram. Then also, further reason is given. So Brahmapuram should be interpreted as Param, the Puram associated with Param Brahma. Then, kinche karmaphala nityadana vrutya dahara jnanasya ananda phalatpashrutehe dharasya paratvamidhi. You go to subsequent passage where the Upanishad says that karmaphalam is perishable, is limited. Kadyathaya karma chito lokah kshiyate evameva mutra punya chito lokah kshiyate. Sometimes chita, sometimes jitaha also. So just as the karma is the loka, loka means here bhogyasa. So what the result of the action that you get here by way of serving the master. The servant, the result the servant gets by way of serving the master is limited here. So also the result that one gets by serving the devatas, which one gets in heaven also, is similarly limited. So that passage shows the limitation of result of karma. So number one. Secondly, then it says, then karmanam antavatva phalat moktva atheya atmanam anuvidya vrajanti etamsa satyan kaman teshu sarveshu lokeshu kamacharo bhavati. And so, asa ye. So there, karmana tatphalacha upekshanantaram asa shabdartha. So when you realize that karma, whether it is laukika karma or serving a master, or Vedic karma, performing Vedic rituals to please the devatas, what are the karma is? It is limited. And karma phala, the result of any karma also is limited. So reason why that limitedness of the karma phala is saying is to turn our mind away. When there is recognition that what I am seeking is limitless, then one turns away from anything that is limited. So one turns away from karma. Then one meditates, then the upasana, the meditation is emphasized here. To glorify the dhyana or meditation of vidya or jnana, this is ninda of karma. That give up that karma and focus attention on the knowledge. Here knowledge is the realization through meditation. So they were tadyasa. So asa, ye iha atmanam anuvidya iha jivat dashayameva. Atmanam anuvidya, those as a result of meditation upon the self as Brahman, ahangraha upasana. Even while they are alive, atmanam anuvidya, realizing the atma as instructed by the teacher. Then, etamsa satyam kaman anuvidya, and also realizing the unfailing desires which are also in the self. those who depart, after their departure, Tesham Sarveshu Lokeshu Kamachara Svechaya Charanam. They have the freedom of movement in all the worlds. Apratiyatam Anantam Aishwaryam Ityartha means that they have the Anantam Aishwaryam, the endless glory, with no obstacle. That they have the freedom of movement in all the worlds means that there is no obstacle to their Aishwarya or glory. They enjoy an unobstructed infinite glory. Iti prakruta dharakasha vijnanasya anandaphalatvam. Prakruta dharakasasya. So this is meditation on dharakasha, which is prakruta, which is subject matter from the beginning. So itasmin brahmapure dharam pundarikam veshma dhara asmin antarakasha. So beginning is made with the dharakasha. And that alone is the theme all around. So this is meditation also upon dharakasha. So dharakasasya anveshatvam. So tat anveshtavyam tadva vijignasatavyam iti. Dharakasa is presented as anveshtavya and vijignasatavya. That we should be inquired into and that we should be realized. And then what's the result of that meditation? Anandapalatvam. Therefore also it is very clear that dharakasa should be Parameshwar, because only by realization of Parameshwar that one can gain infinite result and not otherwise. Then says, dharakasasya anveshitvāda siddhau tatra vichāra. The Purupakshi says, you have already taken for granted that tad anveshtavyam tad va vijignasadavyam. So that should be inquired into and that should be realized. So that tat means dharakasa. So Purupakshi says, you have presumed that sarvanama tat means dharakasa. No. Tasmin yadantah tad anveshtavyam. That tat does not mean dharakasa, it means what is within dharakasa. So tasmin yad antah. So tat anveshtavyam. So what is within that? If that is dharakasa, what is within dharakasa is presented here by the Shruti as anveshtavyam and vijignasatavyam. Iti antastha visheshanatvat. So, important thing is anveshtavyam, vijignasatavyam. It should be inquired into and then it should be meditated upon and realized. So, whatever it is the important thing. So far it is presumed that this applies to dharakasha. And therefore, dharakasha is Parameshwara. But Purvapakshi says, no, tasmin antah. So within that, if tasmin is interpreted as dharakasha, then what is within dharakasha is to be meditated upon. So, Bhashyakara said, yadipi etaduktam na dharasi akashasya anveshtavyatvam. It is not dharakasa which is to be realized. Paravisheshanatvam upadhanadidhi. Because tadantastam, what is within that is to be realized. Atra bruma yadi akasho na anveshtavyatvena uktasyat. If dharakasa was not presented here, as that is to be known and meditated upon and known. Yavanva ayam akasha, tavanesha antarhudaya akasha. then this dharakasha is compared to this vast space outside. Iti akasha swarupa pradarshanam na upayujyeta. Then Shruti will only talk about that which to be meditated upon. So if what is within dharakasha is to be meditated upon, then Shruti would have expounded that. Here, Shruti in fact expounds upon the dharakasha itself by comparing with the vast space. So then that must be what is to be meditated upon. And therefore, akasa swarupa pradarshanam na upayujyeta. The dharakasha, which is vast in magnitude like the external space, they would not have described dharakasha if there was not to be not the primary subject of meditation. Then continuing the page 226. Tat pratipadanam anyatha upannam iti shankate. Or says Ratnabhava in the line, last but one, uttaratra akasa swarupa pratipadana anyatha anupapatya. Purvam tasya anyashatvadikam iti yatra anyatha upattim shankate. See, Siddhantin said, it is dharakasha which is presented as the object of anveshanam and vijignasa. Because that is what is subsequently described as vast in magnitude. But he says, what is described as vast in magnitude? That anyatha upatyam, it would not have been described vast in magnitude had that not been presented as the object of investigation, meditation. He says, maybe, but then anyatha upatyam shankate. We can actually explain the description of dharakasha as vast and infinite can be explained other way also. Not because it is the object of meditation, but because of some other reason. So if you give anyatha upatyam means what? Since it cannot be explained otherwise, therefore we will go for this explanation. Siddhanti says that Shruti would not have subsequently equated dharakasha with this vast akasha had it not been the intention to present dharakasha as the object of anveshanam and the meditation. Says no. There could be other upapatti also. As to why Shruti described dharakasha as vast, there can be another reason also. If anyatha upapatti, if other reason is provided, then, of course, the conclusion that you derive is not right. So, therefore, the Purva Pakshi provides other reason as to why Shruti equates dharakasha with the vast space can be due to other reason also. So, now, the last line, Vashyakara says, Nanu edapi antarvarti vastu sadbhava pradarshanaya eva pradarshyate tam ched bruyo yadidam asmin brahmapure dharam pundarikam veshma dharusmin antarakasah kim tadatra vidyate yadanveshtavyam yad-vāva-vidhi-jñāsitavyam idhi-ākṣipya parihāra-avasare ākāśa-upamyo-pakramena dhyāva-prasivyādīnām antas-samāhi-tattva-darshanāt. Says, Nanu, objection is that the upapatti, the reason why the Shruti compares dharakasha with the vast space can be explained other way also. Idapi antaravarti vastu sadbhava pradarshanaya eva pradarshate. That dharakasha is called vast akasha Because the Dhara-akasha contains vast things within itself. See, Dhara-akasha contains within itself the entire universe, including the heaven and the earth, and the air and the fire, and the sun and the moon, and the stars and lightning and everything else. So, Dhara-akasha could not possibly contain within itself or accommodate within itself the entire universe had it not been vast in itself. So, vastness of Dhara-akasha is described for showing how that vast Dhara-akasha accommodates within itself the entire universe. So, then there is something within that Dhara-akasha. That is what the intention is. So, vastness of Dhara-akasha is described to show that there is something within that, namely this universe. So, Tadantastham, that's the point. It is to describe, not Tat means Dhara-akasha, to describe Antastham, what is within Dhara-akasha, that subsequent description is. So, Etadapi Antarvarti Vastu Sadbhava. Sadbhava means the presence of Antarvarti Vastu, something which is within the Dhara-akasha, Pradarshanaya, for demonstrating or showing the existence of something within the Dhara-akasha, that description is given. How? Katham etad avagamyate? How do you come to this conclusion that the subsequent description of vasana of Dhara-akasha is to describe something else? What is within it? Tam ched bruyu yidam asmin brahma pare dharam pundarikam veshma. If the disciple should ask the teacher, then yidam asmin brahma pare dharam pundarikam veshma, in the city of Brahma, there is this body, there is this dwelling place of the shape of the lotus. Dharam asmin antarakasa, in the lotus of the heart, there is even smaller space. Kim tadatra vidyate yadanveshtivyam. What can possibly be there which is to be investigated? Yadva vijignasadabhyam, and which is to be realized. What can be there? Idi akshipya. So, nothing can be there. Akshipya is what? The objection is. What can there be there? Parihar avasare. Then sabruya, you know. So then this is what he says. Sabruya yavanva ayam akasha. Tavanesha, antarude akasha, etc. And he should reply this. So this is called parihara. The doubt that was, the objection that was raised by the disciples was refuted by the teacher. That's called parihara. Parihara avasare, on the occasion of refuting that objection of the disciples. Akasha upamya upakramena. So, yavanva am akasha. So, this vast space is presented as upama, is a standard of comparison. So, tavanesha antarude akasha. Then, upakramena, by describing dharakasha as vast as the external space. Then, says asmi uve asmin dhyava prasivi antareva samahite. So then, within that Dhara-akasha included the heaven and earth and everything. So then there is something within that Dhara-akasha, understand? So that purpose of description is to say that there is something within Dhara-akasha. Dhara-akasha is vast, all right. But purpose of describing vastness is not to present it as an object of anveshan. The vastness is described to convey that there is something within that Dhara-akasha, namely the universe consisting of heaven and earth, etc. Therefore, anyatha upatti. What is upatti presented as siddhantin? That the Shruti would not have described the vastness of Dhara-akasha had it not been the object of anveshanam and inquiry and meditation. She says, no, that vastness of Dhara-akasha can be interpreted as described for describing, saying that there is something within that Dhara-akasha. So this is how the Ratna Prabha now explain. So etat, what is etat? Akasha Swarupam. Antarvarti Vasvadva Pradashanaya. Aksha Bijam Akashasya Alpatpam Upamaya Nirasya Parihar Avasare. So Niras Avasare, while refuting the smallness of the Dharakasha Akasha Akshava Bijam. What is the Akshava Bijam? What was the cause of the objection raised by the disciples was Dhara, smallness of Akasha. So Alpatva Upamaya Nirasya. No, Alpatva Upamaya Nirasya. The smallness of Dharakasha was refuted by the teacher, by comparing with the external space. Antasthavastu uktehe, having removed the idea of smallness in Dharakasha, then teacher proceeded to describe what is within that Dharakasha. Tadantasthaneva dhyayamiti yathaya, therefore, is not Dharakasha which is meditated upon, but what is within Dharakasha is to be meditated upon. Sri Ratnavattarahi Jagadeva Dhyam Shadidhi. What is within Dharakasha is the universe. So does it mean that the Shruti means to present this universe as an object of meditation? So Naira Deva. Since Nyanyanitasya Adharamatattva Vivakshayam Adhyasyeva Dhyetvam Syadidhyah. Then Antastrastutya. The Purupakshi says that the Dharakasha is merely the Adhara, is a receptacle or a container of the universe. That is all the Dharakasha is. If this was tasya adhara matra tvavakshayam, if the description of Dharakasha as vast like the space was intended merely to present Dharakasha as the receptacle or the container containing all this, then dhyetvam syat, then what is adhyam, what is within alone that becomes the object of mentally jagat? So Vashyakara says, naeta devam. No, the way you explain is not right. Meaning the reason, your explanation that the reason for calling Dharakasha as infinite is not for presenting what is within that Dharakasha, because then that what is within will become the object of meditation, understand? And that cannot be. Says Vashyakara, evam hi sati yadantas samahitam dhyava prasivyade tadanveshtavyam vijignyasatavyam cha uktam syat. Ivami sati, with the intention of describing Dharakasha as vast was only to point out the presence of something within that, and then that would become the object of meditation. Yat antas samahitam dhyava prasivyadi, then the heaven and earth and everything else that is included within that Dharakasha, tat anveshtavyam vijignasavityam vijignasavyam to uktam syat. And that would become the object of anveshanam and vijignasa. Astuko dosha, alright, let it be. Let the Upanishad present the universe as the object of meditation, alright. Ko dosha syat. So what's the problem with that? The Vashyakara says, tatra vakyaśeṣaḥ na upapadyeta. If that is so, so tatra, if that is the explanation, then dhara-akāśasya prakṛtasya tatra vakyaśeṣaḥ na upapadyeta, then what is described later on will not be consistent. No, vakya shesha. So understand that Upanishad doesn't stop there. Upanishad goes ahead further. Is Atma, etc. is also said. So that this that universe which you meditate upon is not Atma. Apahata Atma. That cannot apply to that. So, Vakya Shesha na Upadyeta. Even Upapatti explanation for this description of Dharakasha is vast. But subsequently what is stated about object of meditation is that it is Atma, so that would not be tenable. So, is Nyayamirana Dharakasasya Prakrutasya Edat Sabdena Paramarshat Tadvedanasya Phalavattva Shrute Tadevadhyayam. So why? Bhashyakara continues. Asmin kama samahitaha esh atma abhata paatma itihi prakritam dhyava prasivyade samadhana adharam akasham akrushya atha ye iha आत्मानं विद्यव्रजन्ते एतां ससत्यान् कामान् इति समुच्चयार्थेन च शब्देन आत्मानं कामाधारम् आश्रितांश्च कामान् विज्ञेयान् वाक्यशेषो दर्शयति. So, tatra vakyashesha na upadyeta. If what is meditated upon is what is within that dharakasa, then that will not be consistent with what is said subsequently. What is said subsequently? What is vakyashesha? Asmin kamaha samahitaha. So, then subsequently it is said, you know, tam chet bruyu, etc. So what if this body gets old and what? If the body gets destroyed, would the dharakasa also get old? So no. The old of the aged body, decrepit body, does not make this dharakasa deform, or the destruction of the body does not destroy. Having said that, esha atma apahita paapma vijara vimruktyu vishokaha vijigitsaha vivasa satyakama satyasankalpaha etc. Then, yathayaya praja anuvavishanti asmin kaha sa bruyat na etas asya jarayaja jiriyate na vadin asya hanyate etas satyam brahmapuram asmin kaha samahitaha. This is the Brahma, real Brahmapuram. Brahma eva puram. Not a Brahmana puram, Brahma eva puram. That dharakasa is Brahma alone. Asmin kamaha samahitaha. In that dharakasa, all the desires also are located. So question was, why do you say the desires are located? Everything is located. Why specifically mention desires are located? So Bhashyakara said that, look, you people are running out in the world to fulfill your desires and gaining objects of desires. But understand that in dharakasa itself, all the objects of desires are there. All the pleasures you gain out of the desirable objects also is all there. Therefore, stop chasing the happiness outside. Withdraw your mind from the preoccupation of the external objects. And look where the desirable objects or the pleasures are, which is dharakasa, which is yourself. And therefore meditate esha atma. So asmin kamaha samahita. So what is to be meditated upon is where all the desires are also located. Asmin. So that's one sarvanama, asmin. In this. And then esha atma, apahata atma. This Atma, this one is Atma. Esha Atma. This one is Atma, which is Apahata Atma. So Asmin and Esha, these two Sarvanamas are there. So even Ratnaprabha said, Sarvanamabhyam Dharakasam Akrushya. So both these pronouns, Asmin and Esha, refer to Dharakasam. Because Sabruyat Nasya Jaraya Eta Jiryati Navade Nasya Hanyate Eta Satyam Brahmapuram Asmin Kama Samahita. Oh, this is a description of Dharakasha. So understand that Dharakasha is the subject of discussion there. First comparing Dharakasha with the external space and calling it vast, and also the locus where the whole universe is located. Then about Dharakasha again, the disciples asked, that since the Dharakasha is within the heart, and heart is within the body, therefore, what happens when the body gets old? What happens when the body gets destroyed? Would not that Dharakasha, so when body gets old, the heart also gets old, then the Dharakasha also should get old? The body gets destroyed, then the heart will get destroyed, then Dharakasha also should get destroyed. So then what's the point? Therefore, the reply was, Sabruyat. And so, na asya jaraya etat jiryati. So asya jaraya etat jiryati. Asya sharirasya jaraya etat Dharakasham jiryati. The old aged body does not make this Dharakasha deformed. Na vadena asya hanyate. Asya dehasya vadena. So etat na hanyate. By the death of this body, the destruction of the body, this doesn't get destroyed. Etat satyam brahma, etat means what? Dharakasam, satyam brahmapuram. The Dharakasa is the true Brahman. Because the brahmapuram, that is the body, is only figuratively brahmapuram. It's not real brahmapuram. This Dharakasa is Brahman alone is real brahmapuram. Asmin kama, asmin Dharakasa. Kama samahitaha, isha atma, isha dharakasa atma. So by this pronoun aspuram asmin, and isha is dharakasa which is indicated. And then, so further, iti prakritam dhyava prasivyadi samadana adharam akasham akrushya. So by these two pronouns asmin and isha, if Dharakasha in fact is alluded to, is referred to. What is Dharakasha? Which was described as the Adharam, the very locus of Samadhanam, inclusion of the Dhyava, Prithivi and everything. So Dharakasha will be described as the very locus where the entire universe consisting of heaven and earth, etc. is located. That alone is real Brahmapuram. And that is where all the kamas are there, and that is the Atma. Akrushya. And then, Atha ye ihe Atmanam anuvidya vrajanti. Yesha Atma. Apahatapa Atma. So what is Atma? Dharakasha is Atma. Not what is within Dharakasha. So yesha, here, because the topic is Dharakasha. The questions are about Dharakasha, replies are also about Dharakasha. So question is not about what is within Dharakasha, Dharakasha itself. And therefore, all along it is Dharakasha which is the subject matter of discussion. So ye hai Atmana Manuvidya, Dharakasha itself is Atma, and so knowledge of knowing the Atma in keeping with the instruction of the teacher. Vrijanti, those who depart from this body, etam satyan kaman anuvidya, and also knowing Atma as well as the unfailing desires. Iti samuchyatena cha shabdena. So what is Atmanam anuvidya vrijanti, etam cha kama satyan kama. So this Upasaka knows both these things, knows Atma as well as the unfailing desires in the Atma. So, cha shabdena samuchyana, means he knows both of them. So means end. So knowing Atma as well as the Satyan Kaman unfailing desires. Atmanam Kamadharam Ashitamsa. So knowing Atma which is Kamadharam, which is the locus of all the desires. And Satyan Kaman Ashitamsa Kaman. And the unfailing desires which are located. So locus as well as located. Locus is Atma. And what is located is the desires, knowing both of them. So knowing Atma along with the desirable objects, because that is where the fruit is. Knowing Atma is okay. But then what is the incentive of knowing the Atma? Because all the desirable objects are located in Atma. And therefore, subsequently say, you know, Esha Atma, Ya Atma, Avadapapma, etc., etc. Anvestavya, Vijignasitavya, and then it will say that, so one who knows Sarvan Kam, Sarvan Lokan, Apnodi Sarvam Shakaman, in later on it will say, the knower will attain all the worlds, or all desirable objects, as well as all the worlds. And so, it is a Kaman which is the incentive. Atma is not the incentive right now. What is we meditate upon is Atma. But why? Because Atma contains all the desirable objects, understand? So knowing Atma along with all the kamas or desires or desirable objects which are located. So knowing locus that is Atma and all the desirable which are located, knowing both of them. Vakrasesho darshayati. This is what the complementary passage shows. And this will not fit with meditation upon the universe. It's only fit with meditation upon the Dharakasha, which is Atma. So, Sarvanamabhyam Dharakasham Akrushya Atmatvadi Gunanutva Gunaisaha Tasyeva Dhyatvam Vakyasheshu Bruyate. So Atmatvadi Gunanutva, the Dharakasha is Atma, Abhadapapma, Vijaraha, Vindutva, Gunanutva. Gunaisa, then Tasya Dhyatvam, what is then? Asmin Kama, Samahitaha, all these gunas are there. And then Gunaisa Dhyatvam, Atma is to the reason why the gunas, all the attributes of Dharakasha are described is because Dharakasha is to be meditated upon, along with the attributes. As we said, the meditation is about Saguna Brahma. So upon Brahma, various gunas or qualities are superimposed for the purpose of meditation. Here also upon Dharakasha is Atma, Apahatapapma, Vijaraya, Vimrutyu, Asmin Kama, Samahita, all these are various gunas or attributes of Atma. So Atma is to be meditated upon along with his attributes. So guna is a Tasyeva Dhyayatvam Vakya Shesho Bhruyate. So subsequent Vakya, the stream passage says that it is Dharakasha along with all the attributes that is to be meditated upon. And therefore, Upanishad doesn't talk about meditation on what is within the Akasha. It talks about meditation about of Akasha along with its attributes. And therefore, this interpretation that what is within Dharakasha is object of meditation will be contradicted by what is described subsequently. So, Vakya Shesho Tad Virodha Ityartha. If you look at Nyayana, same thing. Dharakashasya Prakrutasya Etat Shabdena Paramarshat. So, Asmin Kamaha is Etat Shabda. Asmin Kamaha Samahitaha. So, Asmin means Dharakase. Tad Vedanasya Phalavatva Shrutehe. Ye Atmanam Anuvidya. Then, one attains all the desires. So, then, Sarveshu Lokeshu Kamacharo Bhavati. That is the result. And so, Tad Vedanasya Phalavatva Shrutehe. The meditation upon that brings about the phala of the free movement in all the worlds. Tadevadhyayam, so that alone is to be meditated. Because what is fruitful alone? So phalavat, what is fruitful alone is to be meditated upon. Then he says, etat means what? Asmin kamaha samayitaha. So asmin means what? Nacha etat sabdena dhyava prasivyam vyavadhanat na akashanam. You see, what has happened is, etat satyam brahmapuram asmin kamaha samayitaha. Esha atma apahadapatma. So, before that, in fact, idam brahmapure sarvam samayetam sarvanaja bhutani sarveja kamaha. So it is said. So therefore, all of this came in between. So edat sabdena dhyava prasivibhyam vyavadhana. So in between the dhyava, prasvi, etc., all of these also come between etat and this object of meditation. Now akash, akarshan, the etat does not mean akash. Meaning the akasha does not immediately precede the word etat. Other things precede like dhyava, prasvi, etc. Asmin eshayati cha ekvachanat tasyeva. So, so don't say that just because dhyava prasavi come between etat and akash and therefore etat does not refer to akash. It does. Asmin esha, because dhyava prasavi etc. is all bahuvachana, understand. Dhyava prasavi and surya chandramasu agnischa vayusha etc. So many things are there. Etat is singular. Esha also is singular. Therefore ekvachanat tasyeva paramasha yogyatvat. So, there akasha, which is ekvachanam alone, can possibly be referred to by the pronouns esha and etat and asmin and esha. Therefore, these two pronouns refer to dharakasha and not what is within dharakasha. Then says, satyakama vedas chedat phalam. Tad anantaryat na dharakasha buddhehe. So this phalam. So he attains, so that sarveshu loke tesham satyan kaman. So you see, iha atmanam anuvidya vijan etam sa satyan kaman tesham sarveshu lokeshu kamacharo bhavati. Sarveshu lokeshu kaman is the result. It is preceded by satyan kaman. So it is the movement, free movement in all the world is because of knowing satyan kaman and not knowing atma. So this is just, you know, satya kama vedana setat phalam tat anantaryat. So satyan kaman and knowing that. So the dharakasha buddhe. So dharakasha is earlier. So athaya iha atman anuvidya vidyante etamsa sarvan kaman. So he says samudharva bhashyaka samuchya. That both are to be known. Dharakasha as well as the satyan kaman. Knowing both of them, the result is sarveshu lokeshu kamachara. Sandigdhasya vakya shesha nirde nyayad. So when there is a doubt about how to interpret a given passage, you should also take into account what follows later on to explain this passage. Sandigdhasya, that about which we have sandeha or doubt. Vakya shesha nirnaya. We can arrive at the conclusion understanding by taking into account what is said subsequently about that. Iti nyayat adav tasmin idanta iti tachshabda antaram akasham abhilangya hrut pundarikam paramushati. So we said in the very thing, you know, so tasmin yat anvestavyam, that tasmin rather than referring to akasha, so abhilangya, so crossing over that akasha goes with durdaya, your pundarika, and therefore Vrutpundarikam Paramrshati, that Tasmin should mean Vrutpundarikam and not Akasha. Then Dharakasha becomes the object of meditation. Tatra antarakasam tadanveshtam vijignasatabhyam cha iti upasamari tasmat. Therefore, tasmin in the very first sentence should apply to the pundarikam veshma and not dharakasam. So Mahashekara says, tasmat vakyopakramevi dhara eva akasah hrudaya pundarika adhisthanah saha antasthaihi samahitaihi prithivyadibhi satyaisya kamaihi vigneha uktah iti gamyate. So in Bhashyakara gives a concession. Says Ratnavara, tasmin yantayeti tatpadena vevitamvirudam yogyata grahyam tasmat vakyopakramepi dharaiva akasha hrudaya pundarika adhisthana. Therefore, that tasmin means dharakasha. So therefore, dharakasha is the object of meditation. And then suppose tasmin goes to dharakasha, what is within dharakasha? So what is tasmin applies to both, he says. Tasmin is what? Hrudaya pundarika. And tasmin dharakasha. Then what is within the hrudaya pundarika is dharakasha. That should be meditated upon. And what is within the dharakasha, all this universe and stuff, that also is meditated upon. You can interpret that way also. So therefore, says yadva akasha tasminanta tadubhayam anveshtavyam. So what is within the heart and within the dharakasha, both of these are presented as anvesham and vijignyasa. Iti yojana. So saha antasthai samahitai. You can say that dharakasha along with the satyakama, along with the dhyavapurthvi, all of these is to be. So all of these are gunas of dharakasha. Dharakasha is meditated one with all these gunas. So tasthai samahitai prasivyadevi satyashyakamahi vignyavuktahiti gamyate. So therefore, the dharakasha along with what is within is presented as the object of meditation and realization. Irigamyate, this is what we conclude. So if that word tasmin is applied to both the hrudaya pundarika as well as dharakasha. Etat should only refer to what is in the immediate proximity. Jivatmana sarvan prati sannhita taratva. In fact, not even akasha, not even what is within akasha, it is jivatma that is the most proximate. So etat should refer to jivatma. Tasiva tadarthyat kamanamcha tatya samahitam tattvena, and kamas also are located in jivatma. Samuchya siddhehe. So knowing jivatma along with the satya kama, tat param vakyam, this vakya is for meditation upon jivatma along with satya kama iti asankya. So whether the vijnanatma or jivatma can be referred to by the pranam etat or not, vijatya adyakshad siddha jivat. So jivatma is vijatya. Why? Because whether jivatma is there or not is only decided by the adyaksha, by the witness. So the existence of jivatma can be determined by the witness, which is vijatya. So adyaksha siddha jiva is vijatya, sajatya, shruti siddha dhara, but shruti quite directly says, so by linga or by shruti, shruti directly talks about the dharakasha, and therefore dharakasha alone is referred to by this pronoun rather than jivatma. Laghavat. So you go to jivatma and then dharakasha, but rather than that, dharakasha itself is referred to by shruti. Jiveche apata papatvadi ayoga, then jiva cannot be apahata papma. Jiva is always limited. And jiva is the product of the identification with the upadhi. So therefore ahankara, mamakara is always there in jiva. So papa is always there. So jiva cannot be apahata papma. Only paramatma can be apahata papma. Therefore, vakya bhedapatte, then one vakya apahata papma will apply to paramatma, and satyam, then kaman will apply to jivatma. There will be two vakyas. Therefore, that cannot be. So therefore Bhashyakara says, Sacha uktebhyo hetubhyah parameshvaraiti. What is sacha? Dharakasha. Uktebhyo hetubhyah that have been stated subsequently, so that dharakasha is parameshvara and not anything else. Okay, so dharaha uttarebhyah. That dharaha or dharakasha is parameshvara because of the hetus or the reasons presented subsequently. So that is this sutra, and here we'll take a break from Brahma Sutra and go back to the next section of the Chandogya Upanishad in the next class. Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Veda Vibhagine Tadehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namaha Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om. See, this vakya is